One of the most impressive features within Wyoming is a towering monolithic edifice called Devil's Tower. This ancient mass of rock contains hexagon-shaped columns which rise 867 feet above the surrounding landscape. Yet, despite how famous this beautiful rock formation is, little was known about how it formed until recently. This video will discuss a new theory on how Devil's Tower formed and mention some nearby related geologic features. And yes, according to this theory, Devil's Tower is believed to be the remnant of an ancient volcano. Devil's Tower is located in the northeast corner of Wyoming, where it is only 28 miles from the southern border of Montana. Before Devil's Tower was created, the area was a near-coastal environment during the Triassic period, approximately 220 million years ago. Over the course of many subsequent millions of years, large volumes of sand and other fine particles were left behind. These particles later cemented together to create various sedimentary rocks forming the surrounding landscape. Based on their coloration, you can easily identify three of these rock units. By 157 million years ago, a several thousand foot thick grouping of various sedimentary rocks towered over the surrounding landscape, much like what is seen today in southern Utah. Then, around 50 million years ago, a large volume of alkali element-rich magma intruded into this section of North America. Creating a swarm of earthquakes, these got stronger and shallower over time until the rising magma began to interact with an abundance of groundwater at about 2,000 feet beneath the surface. The heat from the nearby magma transferred into the present groundwater, causing it to rise in temperature, eventually flashing to steam. Since this steam took up 1,600 times the volume of the water it once was, it caused an immense amount of pressure to build. Eventually, this pressure became so great that it cracked and thus broke through overlying rock, exploding upwards from a depth of 2,000 feet in a powerful blast via what is termed a phreatic eruption. As boulders of rock were thrown several miles, pyroclastic flows raced across the surrounding landscape. By the time this eruption was over, a 4,000-foot wide and 1,000-foot-deep crater termed a mare remained in the landscape. This crater, which was filled with significant debris at its bottom, would eventually become the site of Devil's Tower. Due to the same magmatic intrusion sourced from an underlying laccolith, 3.5 miles to the northwest, four similar, albeit smaller, intrusions of magma occurred at shallow depths, although it is uncertain if these two created a series of explosions. Eventually, large volumes of highly viscous magma began pushing its way up through the debris at the bottom of the Mare crater, forming a very tall and fairly thin mass of molten rock, which may have even breached the bottom of the crater at one point. After the intrusion ended, the magma began to cool in a largely top-down manner due in part to the geothermal temperature gradient. As this occurred, the magma contracted, and the best way to accommodate this motion was to form a series of near 120-degree angle cracks that eventually formed polygon shapes, albeit primarily six-sided hexagons. These hexagon-shaped cracks then propagated downwards, as once the process began, going further down required less energy. By the time the cooling had completed, a series of hexagon-shaped columns, some of which were up to 10 feet wide, stood in this vast crater. These columns were built out of a rock type called phonolite. Over the following millions of years, the softer overlying rocks were eroded away, while the layers of phonolite rock, which were far more resistant to erosion, largely remained in the landscape. By 5 million years ago, Devil's Tower became exposed on the surface, with erosion later cutting sufficient elevation from surrounding rock units to create its modern towering monolithic appearance. To the northwest, the other igneous intrusions were also eroded, thus leaving behind four buttes referred to as the Missouri Buttes. I do want to note that the theory of how Devil's Tower formed is one of several reasonably possible explanations. However, I feel that this theory is the best match given the available evidence. Also, I don't know why this even needs to be said, but Devil's Tower does not, I repeat, not represent an ancient tree, and anyone who claims otherwise is saying complete nonsense. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member, Carolyn Stargazer, for supporting my work.